Before we start drawing or painting, let's look at our reference and think what the goals are and what we're aiming for. This is a photo of my friend Naomi, and here we can see that there's quite a lot going on. The blurred night cityscape. Here we could study and practice linear perspective and architecture. Also notice Naomi's pose, a contrapposto. Notice her hand is resting on her collarbone and the tilt of her head. The next is quite exposed and defined. And there's also this very complex hairpiece. Also notice her pose, how it's suggesting that she's about to step forward. And just at the bottom right, we can just see the other hand with her fingers poking out of the sleeve. Regarding her dress, her kimono, notice how her patterns, very subtle, very simple geometric shapes. She has a belt or obi that is very dark and quite textured. The lighting is coming from the top left corner from the viewer's point of view. This is clearly suggested, or it can be more clearly seen by looking at the cast shadows, especially on the neck, nose, and under the hand. So most of our subject is in just light and mid-tone, where it makes the form or the description of the form very subtle. This is all the things that we can see. There are far more than this. There's far more detail and far more nuances to be noticed. But I wanted to point out the most obvious and therefore the most important ones. I very much like the structure of the whole shape going towards the head, almost as a thin triangular composition. It goes from bottom up and we have a resting place at the hand, neck, and ultimately our main focus, her head or her face. This is reinforced by the value structure, where the contrast between the lights and the darks is much higher. And you'll notice that the contrast is much less at the bottom half of the picture. This is also supported with the tones or values of the background. Now, before we start, I also think it's important to set a limit to yourself about what you're going to use in terms of medium and materials, as well as your palette in terms of value range and color schemes or color palettes, and how long you're going to spend on it. Now I'm going to limit this to a black and white portrait where I'll use roughly 3 hours. All this is to force me to make more decisive decisions, trying to recreate digitally and from a photo the circumstances of working from life. I think it's easy to have these limitations imposed because it will force me make decisions within that, especially what's important and what is not. Having limitless possibilities, limitless time, I think it's very easy to get lost in it, losing sight of what is important and getting more and more caught in the meaningless details. I also making a decision that this is not about copying as faithfully as possible, but to trying to distill the information and to re-represent as simply as I can and as powerfully as I can. My definition of drawing is fundamentally a process of decision making. What, where, how, and how much of it. Balancing all these decisions together as we stack them slowly onto each other like a house of cards. To make the process of decision making easier, having a goal or purpose, I find it helpful. Use it as a compass when it comes to making decisions. This could be a story, a concept, an idea, a feeling, or a specific technical element like anatomy or form. For this, let's keep it simple. The idea is portrait of Naomi in her kimono. Any decisions that I'll make is in order to support this goal. Beyond it, elements that don't support or reinforce this, I'll simply be ignoring it or actively taking them away. This is also good to do from a practical point of view because of time limitation, to bypass any unnecessary work and have a sense of direction. For this, I'm going to completely ignore all the architecture and linear perspective of the background and all those lights and keep it as simple as possible by having it completely neutral, flat. Another point to consider is framing and composition. When considering a decision, I have to always keep in mind my goal, Naomi in a kimono. If it's only about a portrait, I may even cut it from the neck down. But since it's also about the kimono, I'll make sure to include it. So the more clear you can be about your goal, the easier it becomes when making decisions where possibilities can be endless, or in other words, aimless. With our goal in mind and understanding where our main focal points are, and with the decision to ignore the background, I settle down with this composition. I cannot stress enough the importance of looking and planning before we get into drawing. So let's get started. Now, when I'm looking at the photo, I'm making sure that I'm ignoring all the detail, all the nuances that I see, and I'm going to focus on just the overall shape. I'm only concerned with the overall shape and its basic proportion. Is it too wide or too narrow? Not at all worried if there's any small scale mistakes. At this point, it's about big shapes. If my big shapes are correct, I don't have to worry later with big mistakes. So it's also important to simplify the shapes with big long lines, never stopping for intricacies. The general impression is the aim here. Make sure to draw this stage loosely and lightly, because we are going to use this only as a base to draw on more complex and accurate shapes. Once we got the overall big shape, we move on to medium shapes. It's still important to always pay attention to proportion, how big or small each individual shape is relative to one another. And within each shape, still try to keep as simple as you can. So the general rule is big to small and simple to complex. Only after getting all my major shapes, I move on to blocking facial features, but still maintaining as simple as possible, and I'm only concerned with my major proportions. The next step is to start thinking about values or tones. Let's identify the value range we are working with and simplify our subject into major value groups. Here we have the value range or possible tones of our medium, and this is the value range of our subject. If you wish to change the mood or play with the contrast, don't feel like you have to stick to this range. What is important is to understand the limitations of our medium and play within that. There are many ways to start here. For this demo, I start with low contrast and middle key. I will slowly push the values outwards, increasing its contrast. It can be helpful if you find hard to judge contrast against a very light background to tone it down to its major key or the overall tone of the picture. Now, when we simplify our subject to as few values as possible while retaining its readability, we can reduce down to about three values: a light, a middle, and a dark group. If you find hard to visualize this in your mind, try squinting and see how the values merge into groups. One of the advantages of starting low contrast is that it allows us to have just a little more room for mistakes. When we make a mistake, it will not stand out, and we can always fix it later as we push our contrast. Now, as we start introducing values, keep in mind to approach values also with drawing. Keep considering its size, shape, placement, and proportion, and not just its tone. Values are also a great tool to show form and three-dimensionality. As a general rule, values get lighter the more it faces the light, and darker as it faces away. So when using values, it's important not just to think of tones as shapes, but also as planes. Think of using values almost as if you were sculpting with clay. Now that we establish a bit of the general picture, I'm going to focus a little more on our focal point. Notice how I'm using the low contrast lane as guides. At this stage, beware not to fall into the trap of getting tunnel vision. Do only as much you can while keeping in mind of how what you're doing may affect the whole composition. It helps to step back or zoom out. Also helps to take short breaks. When modeling the form in the lights, pay attention to your value range. Understand what is the value range for your lights. It's important to be consistent to it, both for simplicity and clarity of form. In this case, it can be a little tricky as the values are very close to one another. The forms are subtle, but as long as we keep in mind our value range, where the light is coming from, and how much the planes face towards or away from the light, we can model the form in a believable way. Here, I also push the background to darker values. Notice how the dark hair stood out against the lighter background. But now, with the darker background, the hair is almost lost, but the face and the neck become much more prominent, thus keeping our goal and composition to what we set for. I repeat the same principles to different areas. Always big to small, simple to complex, and always in accordance to our goal. Stepping back and zooming out, and keep checking if the whole thing is balanced. Flipping the image can also help you with this. And this is a repetition of all the same steps and principles where you keep pushing and refining and pushing and refining, slowly increasing your values and your contrast and detail where necessary. Remember to look, squinting can help, think, analyze and plan, and then draw objectively and with a goal, and repeat. That's all for this demo. And from me, I'd like to wish you a happy painting.